guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm back with a DIY and I loved how this DIY turned out. I just think it turned out so cute. And the first DIY is they're going to be these cute little jewelry bowls that you can put your rings and your earrings into it. And then the second DIY is probably my favorite DIY of all time. I think it turned out so adorable and exactly how I imagined it in my mind. It is just this antler necklace here that I found some inspiration from Pinterest, and then I just decided to put my own little twist into it. So for this necklace hanger, I put most of my dainty necklaces on there, but you can definitely put more of your bigger statement necklaces if you want to. But I would just recommend that you make sure that the antler is very secure on your wall so that it doesn't fall off, since statement necklaces are a little bit heavier. So yeah, but I'm just gonna use it mostly for my dainty necklaces because I have more dainty necklaces than I do statement necklaces. Yeah, if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to give it a big thumbs up so I know that you guys like my DIY videos. But without further ado, let's just get right into it. Alright guys, we're gonna start off with these rings and earring bowls. I got these glass bowls from the Dollar Tree. They came in a set of 3 for only $1, so super affordable. I'm gonna first start painting the inside white. You can choose whatever color that you like. I just really like white because it's a very classic look. And again, I'm only painting the inside and not the outside, but you can definitely paint the outside too if you want to. After that, we're gonna let that dry and then we're gonna do 3 coats. I'm doing 3, you can do 2 or 3 or more if you want to, but I found that 3 was really, really nice because it gave it a very opaque look. And so this is what 3 coats look like, and as you can see, it's really, really nice and opaque, exactly what we want. And then I'm gonna go ahead and start painting the rim with this gold metallic paint. I just wanted to add a nice pop of color, and most of my jewelry and rings are gold, so I just thought that matched so well. So after that, you let that dry and we're pretty much done. Just go ahead and put the bowls anywhere you want to display them, and go ahead and start putting all of your jewelry in there. You don't have to use it for jewelry. You can use it for like paper clips or lipsticks or whatever your heart desires. So I thought they turned out so cute, and of course I just love that pop of gold. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this one, and then let's move on to the next one. Alright, so this DIY is probably one of my favorites. I think it turned out so cute. So first, what I'm going to do is just start sketching out the antler on these foam boards I got from Walmart for 88 cents. And I just needed like half of one, so you don't really need more than one. And then I'm going to go ahead and cut it with a kind of like a box knife thing, but to be honest, it was really hard cutting it, so just take your time and go slow. So I just switch off and on from X-Acto knife, and then this is what it looks like once it's cut out. I'm gonna go ahead and just put a coat of white paint. Obviously it's already white, but I just wanted to put white just to cover the pencil marks, and also it kind of gave it like a wooden look to it, as if it was wood and you painted over it. So I thought that was pretty cool. And so you just want to do the same thing to the other side of the antler. And so once it's dry, I'm gonna go ahead and again just put some gold paint on the kind of like the outsides of it, again just to add some color. And I just thought this was so cute. Just added the little like pop of gold, which gave it kind of like a very like chic look in my opinion. And so of course you want to let that dry, and then we're going to go ahead and start arranging the flowers. So I would recommend using flowers that are a little bit bigger, just because I think it gives that very like hippie or bohemian look to it. So these are the color schemes that I chose, and I'm just gonna rearrange them how I want them. And then I'm just gonna take some hot glue gun and put that in the back, and then just do one flower at a time and just push down until it dries. And then after that, I decided to add some of the green leaves, just add a little bit of the green color just underneath, just for more color. And I'm just gonna do like 3 leaves, nothing too crazy. Once you're done with that, you just of course want to do the same thing to the other side of the antler. Alright, so this is what it should look like right now. I think it turned out so cute. But of course we want it to be 3D. We don't want to just tape it to the wall. So what I ended up doing was I turned it to the back, and then I used these like small little plastic cups. I hot glue gunned one end to the back of the antlers, and then I put double-sided tape on the other side of the cup and taped it to the wall. But I did end up having to nail it to the wall because the
tape wasn't strong enough. So here I'm just gonna go ahead and put it on my wall wherever I want to, wherever you want to. And then after that, we're just gonna go ahead and start hanging on all of our necklaces. And I thought this turned out so cute. Again, this is probably one of my favorite DIYs. I just love it so much, and I hope you guys love it too. So if you guys try this out, make sure to tag me on Instagram, XOXOXAO, so I can see. So yeah, thank you guys for watching.